What is up, guys? Joey from Stampede Gaming. Welcome back to another episode of Game Breakers. Today we're going to take a look at Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link on the NES. Just some quick tips on some easy boss fights and getting some easy magic in Palace 7. Let's get to it. Alright, so first thing we're going to take a look at is the boss for Dungeon 5. This is called Guma. When you get here, you basically just want to use shield if you can for protection, you know. And jump. You don't really need jump, but just in case. You know, it comes in handy to use. You don't really need any of this magic to pull off this trick, but again, it's just a precaution. So what you want to do as soon as the fight begins, you want to push Guma off to the right side of the screen. So, jump, hit him, jump. Right there, okay. Perfect, that's exactly where you want to be. You want to stand right on these two, on this block here, the second block from the right here. And every time he peeks his head out, you want to hit him. Just like that. So what's happening is that the right side of the screen is preventing him from attacking. You can attack him, but he can't attack you. And there it is. Easy boss fight, guys. Alright, next we're gonna show the Dungeon 6 boss fight. This is Barba. Okay? So the only thing you really need here is shield. I mean, you don't need, again, you don't even need shield to beat the game, to be honest. It's just there for precaution in case he hits you. What you want to do is you want to get to this platform here and stand right there, exactly where I'm at. You want 1 foot off of the platform there. 1 foot on, 1 foot off. Okay. Now he's coming up. He didn't hit you on the way up. Now what's going to happen? He's going to try to spit fire at you. The thing is, though, the game can't make the fire angle that steep. So what happens is nothing comes out, and then you just stab upwards to hit him. So I'm gonna stay here the same way. There it is. And you can hit him one time on the way down as well. Now when he comes on this side, when he comes on that side, you don't want to stand 1 foot over the edge. You want maybe just like your toe over the edge and just stab upwards. Like right there. You can hit him like 3 times at that point. And that's it, that's that boss. And then as a precaution, I always put jump here so I don't want to fall in the lava, you know? Okay, so that's Dungeon 6, guys. Next. Now we're in the Great Palace. So you're gonna come to a part in the Great Palace, two of these areas, where you're gonna come down here, and you're gonna be able to go to the left over here via a secret wall, invisible wall, and get some magic here. The thing is, though, these statues, they have a 50-50 chance of being either magic or an enemy. So you take your chance. If it's an enemy, all you gotta do is let him get to the ground. And bring him to the elevator. And go all the way up. He'll follow you. And let him die. So normally what you're supposed to do in this situation is leave the screen, come back, and recast the jump magic. But this way, you still have the jump magic. And he's gone now. So now you can go back and try again. And there you go. You just saved yourself some jump magic there. Alright. Now, we're in Dungeons, Palace 7 again. Dungeon 7. We're just about to get to the Thunderbird fight. Now, before you get to the Thunderbird fight, if you see you're low on magic and you need some magic, just exit. So normally you would just fight, you would come right from here. So let's say you came right from here, you drop down, and instead of going right to go to Thunderbird, because you know, oh crap, I need magic. Just go to the left over here, and there's gonna be two spots where you can get magic. Now, it's gonna be 50-50, just like before. It's either gonna be the magic jar or the enemy. In this case, it's the enemy. If it's the enemy, just exit the screen. Make your way back. Another enemy. And just keep rinsing and repeating until you finally get the magic. There you go. There's the magic. Now, there, like I said, there's a second jar, and it's right here. So let's say, like, this is already sufficient enough to go for Thunderbird. But let's say you you defeat Thunderbird, and now you want, just in case you want some more magic or health for the Dark Link fight, you got a second one right there. There you go. Two magics, guys. Now, I'm going to show you guys an easy strat to cheese Thunderbird here. So this is all you need. All you need is reflect, jump, shield, and thunder for when he comes out. So you want to stand right here and turn around just like that, just exactly as I'm doing. As soon as he comes out, cast thunder. And just stay put. And don't move. So, similar to the battle with Guma from Dungeon 5, the right side of the screen is your best friend here because he can't hit you. There are gonna be, like, a small percent of chance he may be able to hit you, but I found it rarely to happen. He doesn't hit you at all. So what you want to do here is basically hit him. Now you can't hit him this way. But if you turn around, you'll be able to hit him. So wait for him to come down and out right there. So he's gonna shimmy his way down, and as soon as he goes off screen and back on, that's when you want to hit him. Right. There you go, right there. And you need to jump for this. And see, you jumped up, and because he had Reflect, you blocked his Fireball. I've even found that on the, now I'm doing this on the NES Mini. But I found that doing this on my retro USB AVS, and possibly also on Nintendo, I found patterns where he won't even shoot any Fireballs at all. He'll just do the shimmy without any Fireballs, which makes it much more easier. There you go, guys. Nice cheese fight. Okay. So, like I said, in case you need the magic, you can always go back at that second jar. But I got enough for one more shield magic here. So I just want to use the shield magic here. And just in case you guys don't watch ABGN to know the cheese trick for Dark Link. You want to just go in the corner here. Bottom left corner. You want to cower like a wiener and just stab him. There you go. That's it. We just, we sent Dark Link to the Water Temple and relegated him to mid-level boss. That's it, guys. So, other than that, let's start off for Game Breakers, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. It's Joe with Stampede Gaming. See you guys later.
Afternoon.